Magnolia macrophylla, as the name suggests, has impressively large leaves, about 50 centimeters, 20 inches, even larger. In autumn, the leaves fall on the ground, dry, curl, and change color, golden brown on the outside and white on the inside. I think this show of shapes and colors on the forest floor in the fall under this magnolia is as beautiful as the one displayed by the flowers among the branches in spring. I really wanted to add one of these leaves in my journal and use the ink pen to illustrate the brown color and watercolor to add a few shadows on the white area. Because I've already sketched a detailed outline of the leaf in pencil, I will just focus on the ink rendering moving from top to bottom. I had to make a compromise when I photographed this leaf. I usually photograph my specimens with light coming from the left. After I rendered the brown part of the leaf in ink, I want to paint the interior with watercolor. Although this part is white, it shows shadows caused by wrinkles and the cast shadows of the veins. Because this book has a coloring that mixes browns, ochres, and the lavender purple, I chose that purple for the shadows on the white part of the leaf. So I mix a rose with a cobalt blue and slightly more blue, and I dilute that with lots of water. I want very, very light mix of lavender purple. I start from here and work very slowly, look at the shadows I have and their edges. Some are hard edges, some are very soft, blended with the whites. This part has to remain white, and I'm adding shadow to the edge. The shadows on this part has to be very, very light. I'm just putting patches of light color as texture. I really like the rendering on this part. Just few lines of ink and few patches of light color here and there. As you can see, I'm not even too precise with them. Loose watercolor always look better than the one that is very fine polished, but it's hard to do because you really have to learn to trust your instincts.